Hello everyone and welcome to the next episode. In this one, I guess we will spend some time in Obedon Kingdom and see what it has in store for us. But first, let's go camping. I wonder how it will go this time. It seems to have a fairly random outcome when I do it. Sometimes it's actually quite good and the other times, well, I guess it sucks. So, let's see how it goes this time. Well, it's definitely the latter. But, well, it's always plus 8% attack, so let's use one of those camping skills. And now that I see it, I messed up. I thought that is a wyvern meat, but it is some wyvern egg, I just didn't read it. So that skill was useless, basically. So yeah, let's check out what's going on now. Well, this is new. I guess we have a camping event? Well, yeah, that fire looks cozy enough. Yeah, what do you want to know? I guess we found him, if I remember from the bio. Okay. Oh. Dang. So, I guess Paya is an orphan. Good boy, Chico. Oh. That's cool. Yep, it's our little patchwork family. Aww. That was quite nice, and we got some background info. More than there was in those bio shorts on the character's party screen. So that's kind of interesting. Well, doesn't look like much of a farm. Hope you had more than those two cows, because it's not looking good for you, man. Yeah, I bet you have other problems. I don't know if you can do anything, Peony. He's right. Oh, well, man has tried everything. That's peculiar. Well, yeah, we see water there. Guess Kicken's the one that's doing something here. Don't know, maybe some magic, curses, or other stuff. Bet he's actually has something to do with those satire stones and whatnot. I got a feeling that, you know, when we met those corrupted monsters, that he can somehow do the same thing to those crystals. And instead of allowing vegetation to grow everywhere, it actually, well, kills the vegetation in a place it was used. Kinda looks like that, actually. So yeah, wondering if this theory is actually right. Guess we'll see further down the road, eh? Okay, this doesn't look that good for us. They don't have a nice demeanor. So what you guys want? Well, I beg your pardon. So what if he were? Fishy, if you ask me. Yeah, I wouldn't think so. You know, he's right. This doesn't look like a talk. Well, Peony's a sucker. Wonder how this will end. Well, I think I know how this will end, but... yeah. So, if the place is named a prison, I guess we all know how this is going to go. Yep. Well, that sucks. I'm afraid we are, man. Yes, so I guess we heard that in one of those story events. Yeah, how do we know? Well, that's interesting. Actually, that's quite a good way of thinking from Kicken. Well, maybe I am, maybe I'm not. See? I see that there are other cells here. I wonder if we get to open them. Guess we'll see. I hope we get to summon our units, because otherwise this will be kinda hard. But seeing as those units have stats here, behind those cells, I guess we can actually release them. We'll try. I don't know if it's a good idea, but I'll try to actually aim for survivability here, so I'll go with another buff. The best one, I think, would be the barrier one, because it actually increases our survivability. The mana barrier is really nice for that. Yeah, so I guess we'll start. That's a rather unfortunate formation, if you ask me, but, well, we'll manage. Oh, crap. Well, this doesn't make it easier. There is always that chance of a surprise crit, or a back attack that I forgot to defend against, so, yeah. Okay, let's open the door. And see if Ruby actually helps us. Oh, she does. So that's nice. And a treasure chest down there. I would like to get it. But let's see how this goes. I'm kind of regretting actually not having the phantom hand on me now. Because, you know, I didn't know that if any leader falls, this will be a game over. So it kinda makes it harder. But, we should get rid of them without problems. There are actually only a witch and a troll here. Okay, that makes the situation a bit harder. Well, I just hope that we have a set amount of reinforcements, and that there will be waves and waves of them. Because that would suck. Oh, Ruby's got quite a nice attack. I wish she would actually go and help us closer to the treasure chest, but I guess she's actually moving towards the escape zone. But that would be helpful, because she could clean everything that's down the corridor. It's a good thing we got that Bone Serpent, actually. Without him, this would be quite a hard fight. Okay. So it doesn't look that bad. We will actually... It's no use attacking with the Grumble one, I think. Let's just heal up. I will leave him here, so that he can act as an additional target for them. And another reinforcement. Well, this doesn't look that good. Let's block the way and go for a protector. Ah, dang. Peony has, well, not a very good range, to be quite honest. Okay, nice. This is actually going quite well on that side. It's a good thing those guys are staying in place. I hope he attacks the Bomb Servant. Okay, nice. It's nothing we can't heal up without problems. Good thing Ruby has about 500 HP. Because this would get messy otherwise. And more reinforcements. I get a strange feeling that this is not a set amount of reinforcements that we'll have. Especially since this is an escape type of mission, so I guess they will be constantly coming here, and that doesn't look that good for us. Now I really wish I had the Phantom Hand, you know. But, well, I guess we gotta make do without it. Let's see how this goes. That nearly finished him. It's more than half of his HP down. Shame Ruby can't actually open the door. Well, at least I think she can. Doesn't look like she moved towards the door. More like towards attacking that enemy. And the troll has an ultra. I hope this doesn't go bad for us. Lucky. That was a lucky evade. Alright, I forgot that he got that fairy kiss. And it has a relatively low cooldown, so this will be quite messy. Kind of fortunate for us that actually that bandit has those reinforcements, because if you remember, he has that isolation skill, so if he's alone and the... wait a second, I'll finish that later. We have some reinforcements of our own. Okay, this is looking better for us now. And continuing what I was going to say, and it's a good thing that the bandit has reinforcements, because he has that isolation, and if he's not in a range of units in, I guess that was 5 cells or squares or 4 squares, he gets a bonus. So yeah, so definitely good that there are reinforcements so that he doesn't get that bonus. And let's go in for an Nova. And nice. I know that this may sound like a stupid thing to do, but I would actually want to go for that leader subdue bonus if I can. So I will try to leave the troll untouched. But I don't think this will go good for us. But well, if you don't try, we won't know. So, this room here will actually not be very threatening. Low amount of damage, we have nice tanking abilities and mana bar regen, as well as a heal, so I guess we're safe here. And those are flying units, while Paya has anti-air, so yeah, guess we're safe. We'll move the Grumble Bunny, guess we'll help Ruby, and I wonder if he can open the doors, so... Oh, crap. I didn't think a troll could come in from that door. So that actually complicates stuff a little. Okay, so let's get that scrap and try to attack the troll. Guarding won't do us any good here, so Yeah, I'll try to block the way and attack the troll. Ideally, I will actually defeat him and the other guy so that they're both down and I can get the treasure chest. And I will go through these guys here and meet up with my main guys. So yeah, I'll try to do it fast. Otherwise, we're in a bad spot, you know. Oh, okay. That is not ideal. I hope Ruby will manage. That taunt is actually quite useful on Python. Especially if it has a healer close, such as Pyre. God, please don't end this. Well, that was a lot of damage. I hope we actually manage to get the Grumble Bunny closer. For now, this will have to be sufficient. Okay, let's go in for a ultra attack. This is the troll's a nice candidate. Well, he has some units around him, so I guess they will actually help him. But this will weaken him substantially, so we'll go for that. And let's take care of this one. Well, I should go for it. I don't want that troll to get away. I mean, heal himself and buff up, but I don't have much of a choice, you know. If I stand in place, this won't get us any further. Now that I wonder it, I wonder if I could stay in place and keep that troll in that space where the door is, and if no more reinforcements could go. That's actually an interesting idea, but now that I move, I guess I won't actually find out. And that other troll's gotten up, so... And Ruby's actually down quite low with HP, so... This is looking hairy. Ah, this is even worse. I guess we should be on time with the Grumble Bunny. I hope he's... At least, I mean, sorry for that. My voice just cracked. And the troll has his ultra up. I hope this won't do much damage. And it didn't. So, okay. And let's continue. Okay, and the best thing is to move here so we can attack everyone that's in range. Bone Servant regenerated, and let's go in for a back attack. I hope this was a good decision. I'll try to buff him up with the mana barrier so he can at least survive a little. And let's get the Silence Talisman. So, yeah, if you're doing this mission, everyone, I hope you got the Phantom Hand, because that would make it much easier. Okay, well, that didn't do much, and he's gotten healed. Crap. But, well, we have two ultras up, so we should take care of him. I hope Ruby will survive, because she's doing quite a nice work there, and I want her to continue killing those reinforcements. That Fairy Kiss is actually quite an irritating ability on them, you know? Okay, he's cursed, so that's really good. And Ruby's down quite low, so I hope the Grumble Bunny will get there on time. Clutch evade, nice. Okay, we'll help Ruby for now. The prisoner can wait. I just hope that if they die, it doesn't mean that we actually failed the mission, so... Well, I don't wanna find out, to be honest. Let's go in for an ultra with Pycon. And the trolls down for the count. Okay, what now? I guess I will go in for an AoE attack. I'm not seeing the Bone Servant surviving this one, to be honest. This will be quite a pinch, and... Well, we don't have anything to heal him with, and... Well, we got the spell, but... You know... It's not a... Big heal, so... He could always get a back attack, and he'll go down after that one, so... Well, I hope he survives long. The best target would be the witch, because she will get comboed. So let's go. Alright, another unit down. So I guess that leaves us with two units here, and the troll. And okay, Ruby. That was actually a great decision. And now what? Oh yeah, he had the ultra up. Well, those are actually great evades from Peony there. I think we would be in a bad spot if he landed, if they landed those two ultras on us. That back attack is quite devastating on the Bone Servant, you know. I don't think it was a good decision to leave those trolls down and not take care of them, but well, if we've done that with one, I guess we'll try with the others. I do want that leader subdue bonus, it is quite useful, but... And it's a shame that the Grumble Bunny has such a bad movement, so we can't actually go in and save them. And by them I mean the Servant and Peony. But let's just buff up and hope that he will... survive this. 3 HP short, eh? Well, that's unfortunate. Let's see how it goes. I guess I'll need to depend on Peony's ultra attack. Hope we'll charge that quick enough. And another one down here. Come on, Ruby. So the bandit's nearly done, and we do have to take care of him because we can't go up the stairs otherwise. So yeah, this one won't fit in the leader subdue bonus, if we actually do get it, that is. I wonder how close we are with Peony on the ultra. And crap. So he'll get in a back attack. And it was quite massive damage from that back attack, so yeah, we're in a bad spot now. And more reinforcements. Nice crit. Okay, we're at half ultra bar. What now? We should get rid of someone. I guess I'll go with the witch, because she can push us. And I wouldn't want that. Oh, and we have the ultra up. I would like them to move to a tighter formation around Peony, so I can actually take care of all of them in one attack. And we'll make our escape. Pycon and Pyas are down here. Ruby and the other guys are finished here also. So yeah. We'll try to make haste with Peony and I guess it would be all. Sounds actually easier than it looks. Because we're in a tight spot, you know. Oh, he went for the Gnomble Banner. Well, maybe that's for the best, actually. Well... Actually, now that I think about it, I should have looked how much damage he could have done. He does have a crappy attack, but maybe it would be sufficient, actually. Well, but no use thinking about that now. Let's just heal up. And what can we do here? We'll go for the witch. And get the troll to move towards us. So we won't need to retreat. I actually want to move forward to help Peony as much as I can. And I guess 3 are the most units we will take with the Nova target. But it's enough. And he got silenced. That's nice. Let's go for the kill. And combo. So I'm not going to bother picking up that stuff that's lying on the ground, because this is looking quite not so favorable for us, if I could say so. And I wouldn't want to repeat this mission, so yeah, we need to actually move. And that's even less desirable outcome. Okay, so... Let's get moving. I think that's the only rational thing we could do. They have 2 units here, so I guess we'll leave the troll to them. And let's move forward, and we will poke the shaman, so we could I guess we will take care of him, but let's get moving. I wanted to say that I will leave him for Ruby, but Ruby is actually rooted, and we are moving forward, so yeah, we'll just move and attack him, and if we get the chance to. Let's buff up Peony, because she doesn't have much HP, and she must survive. Otherwise, it's game over for us. Okay, so the shaman's nearly done. I guess Ruby will take care of him. And yeah, so this is actually helpful that he pushes us. But I guess we'll get pushed back. Okay, not, so okay. Peony is down to 19 HP, that doesn't look good. And we're 1 turn away from the heal, so yeah. I'm hoping for some more clutch evades, to be honest. Well, this is actually the only thing that will save us. Okay, nice, a crit, so yeah, the troll will be downed, and the Unilana will actually waste a turn to revive him, I think. So let's go forward with Paya as much as we can, and as well as with PyCon in the next turn, so we get them more targets to choose between for attacking. And let's hope for a clutch dodge. Nice. This is actually what you wanted to happen. To happen for us. Then another one would be quite okay. And another. Okay, now I guess we're back from that. This is looking a lot better for us. I will go with this one because it will heal us and raise our max HP. So yeah, I will go with this one. And having PyCon close means that the taunt ability will trigger. So. Well, we're kind of safe. I hope, at least. And let's move. We go here so we can attack the troll. And make the Unilana waste another turn. We'll move with Paya to get a quick heal and regenerate some mana barrier on the next turn. Also, the ultra's up. So that's nice. Okay, Ruby. That was a nice decision, actually. Okay, Pycon also has his ultra up. Nice going with those evades. And now that I look at it, she has 60% evade stat. That's really nice. We could probably use her as an evade tank, if we need to actually. No, Pycon's blinded. Okay, so... I don't think it's a good thing for us to stay here much. We have the ultras now, so we could at least burn them, but I will try to move. For now, let's just heal up and I'll just move here and crush those two trolls with the soul mover. And he has no trap. I'll take the mana crystal and heal up Pycon. We will use the ultra like this, but I think it's the wisest choice here. Well, the wisest one would be to actually retreat with everyone, but well, yeah. We actually moved in for the attack, so no use in backing up now. Okay, so he's up, and I guess he will use the ultra. I hope this decision to attack won't cost us the fight. It doesn't seem like it. And let's see what he does. Okay, so this doesn't look that bad. Let's just wait and see how the enemy turns unfold. Because they're actually grouping up quite much. And another delay. Let's just back down here. We can still attack, which is okay. It doesn't seem to do that much, but it actually wastes one enemy's turn because enemies will prioritize picking up someone, so yeah. And I will back up with Paya as much as I can. And I guess I will start heading out with everyone I can. We'll haste Peony and see how far can she go the next turn. Oh, okay, he has that regenerative aura, so yeah, he doesn't need to waste a turn for that, picking up that, reviving that other unit. So in hindsight, I guess that the decision to not go in for the kill on the first down troll was not very good. That can't rewind time now, eh? So yeah, that was even worse. Guess the only logical thing to do now is to back up. We'll heal up, just in case. And let's get going. Okay, Fire's actually unfortunately blocking, but we will move here and use sprint to get a better move on the next turn. Now, good thing that the corridor is quite narrow, so they can only move together like this, so it gives us a nice opportunity to retreat. Okay, let's continue moving. There's no need to assist for now, let's just move here. And, well, maybe let me wait for a second. I just wanted to check if Ruby would attack the Shaman, or if I have to heal Python up, because, you know, those trolls will attack him. Well, it doesn't look that bad. Okay, it's actually quite survivable, so we can move. And now let's see how far Pycon can retreat. Not that bad. So let's move in and sprint. And we'll wait. Okay, so they're going to help us. I thought they were going to retreat once they're close to the escape zone. We will cast the buff on Pycon, because, well, I need everyone to survive. And let's get the scrap. Basically, all we need to do now is to just move, and there's no need to attack anyone. But experience is experience, so let's hit the Gremlin Shaman. Guess Ruby will finish him off. Nice. There is always a chance that the Shaman will root a unit, and, well, it's not the most desirable outcome now. Yep, we're just outside the range of the trolls, so that's okay. The Grumble Bun is not a heavy hitter. And I don't think the other troll will target us. I guess we're clear now. Danger. That's the first time we're seeing it. Well, I guess that's the first time the fight is taking 20 rounds, so yeah. I wonder what it does. It didn't say anything, actually. Okay. So far, so good. Looks like we'll get through this. And one tile short. Let's see what they'll do. Okay, so Pyre's in the clear. Ultra ready. And so, does the danger actually do anything? Oh, a multi-spell. Okay, so note to self. Don't get the danger up in any fight that you can, because, well, this would not end well for us. And I guess this is a sort of a anti-turtling mechanic. I wonder if it's always 20 rounds, or is it a set amount of rounds per fight? Well, I guess we'll see. But now we're actually close to the exit, so let's get going. Sorry for that, I just wanted to check if, after all that we've gone through, the recording software is actually going on. So yeah, I had to alt-tab, and that's where the screen flicker came from. Would be a shame if I went through all this and forgot to actually turn on the recording. But nah, we're good. So let's end this. And we're off. So, thanks guys for helping, and we're going home. I wonder if it actually will change something that we've helped them. And it actually does. So, new party member. We always need a hand. Oh. Okay, so yeah, no new party members for now. But, well, this was a, I don't know if say hard, definitely tedious mission, but we somehow managed to actually win this. So yeah, so that was okay. So thank you all for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.